Guys, listen, I'm not gonna lie, the comedy that I've watched so far today is just not hitting the right spots, and I don't know why. I don't know. It's just been a bad list so far, things that have not really had me laughing that much. So I'm going back to an old faithful, and I know from what I've watched so far of the Inbetweeners, Will is the funniest character there. So this is his funniest moments from season two, and I'm hoping now that this just has me laughing out loud. I'm hoping from beginning to end, I'm just rolling up because yeah, someone needs to make me laugh today. From what I've watched today so far, it's not hit the right spot. So please, Will, come on, save the day. Guys, listen, thank you for tuning in. Please don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. I will be uploading daily. And if there's anything you want me to react to, let me know in the comments down below. But let's get into this.
Scary being you, isn't it?
It's a bit.
The way the kids all threaten to beat you up and call your names like briefcase wanker.
Oh, it's not been like that.
No, it wasn't for me either.
Feisty one you are!
What?
Feisty one you are!
Why are you talking like that?
It was Yoda. From Star Wars. It's the same impression I was doing on the coach for about an hour.
Oh, was that what that was? Oh, good. I thought you might, you know, have a problem.
No.
Or Asperger's, maybe?
Wrong again.
Have you ever been tested for anything?
Good one.
Okay, does seem there's been some sort of mistake here somewhere.
Well, that's okay. Mistakes happen. Shall I go to the paper tomorrow?
No. No. You go to the garage. It's all booked.
Is this a joke?
Do I make a lot of jokes?
But, sir...
I can't change the placements.
Can't or won't?
You pick. It's the same result.
There's a lot of noise down the hall. It sounds like a party. Do you fancy it?
Party? Cool that sounds.
You know you're never ever gonna get laid.
You're all right with me,
Laura, aren't you? Yeah, of course.
She's pretty cool, actually.
Is she?
Fuck off, you baby-eyed little stits!
No offence, but I'm never gonna work in a place like this.
Sorry. Over the past couple of days, I've watched two things with people shouting at birds. This is the second one now. You got him shouting, and I watched Bobcat Goldthwait from the police academy when he was sitting by the lake shouting at the ducks.
You are all right with me seeing Lauren later, aren't you?
Yeah, of course.
She's pretty cool, actually.
Is she?
Fuck off, you baby-eyed little stits!
No offence, but I'm never going to work in a place like this.
Place like this?
Yeah. Place like this. Manual. Dirty. Not stupid exactly, but not academic by a long chalk. It's not that I'm better than this, it's just that I'm much cleverer than you need to be to work here.
Are you okay, Will?
Fine, thanks. Be back for you in a minute.
You know you sent a flare up.
Yup. Thanks, Lauren. Won't be a minute.
Is that a fish?
Yes, Lauren. It's a fucking fish. Give me a minute.
Yeah. Come on, guys. Is this really necessary? What about my allergies?
Come on, let's talk about this.
Please, my allergies!
Surely you've got something better to do this weekend than watch me try to get off with Charlotte. Great, no, fine, see you there then. Ignore everything he has to say, it's all total bollocks, I promise.
Hello? Right? No, I'm not his girlfriend, no. No, we didn't have sex. He did he? No, that didn't happen. No, I'm not a porn star.
Charlotte, listen. I was working in a garage. You don't understand what it's like.
How many chances do you think you're going to get to be a dickhead, Will?
One more?
Oh, shit, who's that?
Could be Northwood.
Who is it?
It's obviously me. What is happening in here? Look, I put a lot of effort into this. I made a really nice cock au vin. Cock of what?
You don't help yourself, do you?
Oh, yes, I see. Cock au vin, very mature. It actually means chicken in wine, doesn't it, Patrice?
What?
Well, it does. And it doesn't mean cock on my arse, or cock on my head, or...
You got some cock in the back of a van.
Oh, that I got a cock in the back of a van. Right,
Looks like it's time for plan B.
Oh, right. There's a plan B, is there? It's just plan A was so brilliantly devised, I wouldn't have thought we'd need a plan B. What is it, climb over her fence?
It's a bit higher than I imagined.
Have you just called through my dog shit?
Yes, Louise, I have. But ask yourself why. The fact that you've excluded us from this party because of some vague rules about popularity is ridiculous. And although it may look like we've climbed over a fence and crawled through dog shit, in fact what we've done is challenged your social apartheid.
Nice T-shirt.
Yeah, good luck, briefcase.
Thanks.
Someone's stolen your sleeves.
Yep, nice one.
All right, where's the rest of take that?
Retro, but a good one.
We're going up to London on Saturday. Clubbing. Do you want to come?
Sounds fun. We'd love to go.
Take that.
Which club are you going to?
We're going to one of the big ones. One of the big, cool ones right in the middle of London.
All right, which one?
The land of...
The sound of...
We usually go to the Astoria.
And that's exactly where we're going. What about me? It's my birthday and I just saw Patrice trying to mount Charlotte, the fucking baguette-eating dickhead frog.
That's a bit racist.
He's made me racist!
So do you go clubbing a lot then?
Me?
Yeah, you.
Yeah, of course. Dancing on the podium, probably. Or up by the speakers, where it's, if anything, too loud.
Great, see you there.
See ya.
Great. Get to the back of the queue, you four-eyed prick.
Sorry, do you mind if I stand with my back to you? I just don't want them to think that you're with me.
No, that's fine.
I'm gonna borrow some shoes.
What?
Hold it, shut!
Oh, no. Look, I'm gonna level with you. I am scared. London scares me. The bouncer scares me. And that man really scares me. Let's just put this one down as another character-forming experience and go home.
Well, I think you've got the wrong end of the stick.
Evidently! So is that it? Shall I just go away and leave you to it?
Yes. Go away.
Fine! Fine! That's the last you see of me!
Actually, I'm glad we've got this opportunity to chat, as there's a couple of things I want to...
Shut up!
Sure.
The headmaster, in his infinite wisdom, has decided it would be a good idea for the sixth formers to participate in the Duke of Edinburgh Award Scheme. I'd like you to coordinate it.
Me? Really? The Duke of Edinburgh representative for the entire year?
Yes.
I am honoured, sir. Thanks very much. Why me?
You're a virgin, aren't you, Mackenzie?
Sorry?
A virgin. You haven't had full sexual intercourse.
No, I haven't.
Well, there's your answer. Now get out.
Maybe we should arrange a weekly meeting just to check on my progress.
You can if you like. But I won't be there.
Or maybe I could compose a regular memo with how it's all going.
Okay. Why don't you drop that in my pigeonhole?
Great. Where's that then, sir?
Any bin. Any rubbish bin you see in or indeed out of the school. Just pop all your thoughts in a rubbish bin and they'll get to me.
What have you got here?
Hair removal cream.
Oh, no way.
Give us a handle. Shouldn't need too much. He's probably only got about four pubes and he pisses through one of them.
You spunked your pants in the common room during the day when there were people around?
Yes.
And then your pubes fell out?
Yes. You are banned from going inside.
Why?
Because you do something like steal my mum's knickers to sniff and then wank with.
With?
Yes, with. And then you'll take great pleasure in telling me how you wrapped my mother's knickers round your cock and used the friction generated whilst thinking about her tits to make you come.
Hello, Will.
Oh. Hello, Mr. Cooper. Sorry if I seem a little stressed. It's just I've got no fucking pubes. Sorry, Simon. I do want your help. Please look at my cock.
No!
What the fuck is this?
Daisy, I'm sorry. Please let me explain.
Is it a wig?
It's a long story, but I've just not got any hair down there. I don't know what happened. I used to have loads of hair down there.
Well,
it went down the sides, all over my balls, and I've still got loads in my arse crack.
How's your revision going?
Yeah, not bad. Pretty good. Got an excellent schedule sorted, colour coded, and balancing my.
I'm so glad I started watching this. That like from the way today was. I really needed something to make me laugh, and this is doing it. I really did. Oh dear, and I know that my laughing overshadows the video at times, and I do apologise. But yeah, I needed this laugh.
My time well. Got some drinks here to help, Pro Plus, that sort of thing.
Right.
And nothing's fucking going in. Nothing. I mean, look at this. I must have read about the accountability of legislatures to citizens 50 times, and I still don't know what it means. I'm starting to doubt if legislatures is even a word. It doesn't look like a word anymore. None of them do. They just look like squiggles on a page.
What is it, though, Mackenzie?
Sir, I need to go to the toilet. Again. Yes.
Sorry?
It'll be the fourth time in an hour. You'll have to wait.
I'm pretty sure you can't do that, sir.
If I have reason to believe you're cheating, I can. And I do. So I have. Now get on with your paper. Oh, God, no.
Phil? Phil?
Oh, no.
Phil?
Oh, Jesus.
I thought it was a fart, sir. I thought it was safe.
It's a long story, Neil, but the salient facts are these. Recently, I've had a bit of a nervy tummy due to stress, I think. And all the...
I've actually seen that one before. And it was the bit at the end that got me. I thought it was a fart. If you've seen my other Inbetweeners reaction videos to when this part came up, you would have... The story of when I shit myself, you would have heard it from then. If you haven't watched that one, then go and watch it. But yeah, I won't retell the story.
I thought it was a fart, sir. I thought it was safe.
It's a long story, Neil, but the salient facts are these. Recently, I've had a bit of a nervy tummy due to stress, I think.
And all the energy drinks and Pro Plus.
Perhaps. And in the exam, I took a risk and it backfired. I went to fart and instead... shit myself.
God, next term. Do you think anyone's going to remember my little accident?
Yes, of course they will.
Well, at least they won't call you Briefcase Mong anymore.
Well, that's good.
No, they'll call you Shit Pants Mong.
Or Shitty Shitty Bang Bang.
Any more?
Wayne Pooney. Take shot.
Dr. Pooh.
The Lion, the Witch and the Specky Kid who shit himself.
We can keep this up all summer, you know.
Brilliant, looking forward to it.
I'm glad I watched that. That's brought my mood up. This is what I like. My mouth is now hurting, my jawline's hurting because of the laughing and things like that. So that's what I like, that's what I want. And listen, I enjoyed this and I do. I've not actually sat and watched a full episode of the Inbetweeners. That all I've done so far is reacted to their funniest parts. I probably should sit down and watch an episode, to be fair. But yeah, they never failed to make me laugh, they never failed to cheer me up. I really enjoyed this. If there is anything else you want me to react to, if there's any other TV programs that you want me to react to, whether it's from the UK or the US, that I'm more than happy to react to. I'm probably not going to do full episodes just yet. It's really windy today. Yeah, I'm not doing full episodes at the moment. I'm just doing like funniest parts, funniest scenes and things like that. I will maybe get round to doing full episodes and that, but at the moment I'm just enjoying what I'm doing. But listen guys, I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, please don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. I will be uploading daily. And if there's anything you want me to react to, let me know in the comments down below and I will get round to doing it. But yeah, until the next time, take it easy, have a nice day and toodaloos.